بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. أما بعد، يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في كلامه المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا قيل لكم تفسحوا في المجالس فافسحوا يفسح الله لكم وإذا قيل انشزوا فانشزوا يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات والله بما تعملون خبير. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, during this time of the year, November, December, there's a lot of social gatherings, get-togethers, and sometimes we are invited to these corporate events or Christmas parties, so-called. Which ones are we allowed to attend and which ones are we not allowed to attend? And how are we to interact or behave? That is the topic for today. In the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal gives us clear instructions. One is that a person makes a deduction, a conclusion, a subtle indication by putting pieces together. For example, Musa alayhi salam became the student of Khidr alayhi salam, and Khidr alayhi salam, being the teacher, gave Musa alayhi salam three chances, three strikes, you're out. So someone can say, you know, a teacher should give a student three chances, but that's a deduction that he has deduced from the Quran. But clear in text, nusus, nassi sarih, clear text, Allah Azza wa Jal gives guidance, not in one or two verses, but approximately seven verses that I'm going to mention today, in which Allah explains how to behave in social gatherings and in our social events. So, first of all, let us be very clear. Islam, alhamdulillah, gives us guidance not only at the micro level, but at the macro level. Not only how to strengthen your bond with Allah Azza wa Jal and with Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, but also how to govern a society. That is the difference between Islam and other religions, that Islam is a comprehensive way of life, not just at an individual level, but also at a collective level. So when it comes to society and friends and family and members of society, when we have these get-togethers, and there's nothing wrong with them because it is a form of entertainment, a lightheartedness, a change of atmosphere, environment, to sit with our friends and family and joke a little. But What can we do? What can we not do? So let us begin. Quran says, وَقَدْ نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ يُكْفَرُ بِهَا وَيُسْتَهْزَأُ بِهَا فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعَهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِ إِنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِثْلُهُمْ. Quran says that we have revealed to you in this book, فِي الْكِتَابِ, in this Quran, أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ, when you hear the verses of the Quran, يُكْفَرُ بِهَا, that they are being denied and rejected, وَيُسْتَهْزَأُ بِهَا, and they are being mocked and ridiculed, فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعَهُمْ, do not sit with them. Another verse, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ يَخُوضُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِ. When you see people ridiculing Islam, then do not sit. فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ, turn away from them, do not sit with them. إِنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِثْلُهُمْ, if you do, then you will be like them. But Quran, being a book of fairness and justice, says حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِ, they are not bad people. They're the conversation that they are engaging in at the moment, that is despicable, that we need to abstain from. So stay away from them until they change the topic of the conversation. Once they change the topic, the theme of the event, then you can attend this gathering. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, "Man kathara sawada qawmin fahuwa minhum." The person who increases the number, the number in the audience, in attendance, فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ As a participant, then he is from them. He has basically lent his support by increasing their numbers. He is considered to be from them. Now, let us understand this gathering. Mufassireen have explained such type of gatherings where Islam and Quran is being mocked and ridiculed. It is haram. And it is not only for this type of gathering, but all gatherings, all such gatherings where any form of haram activity is happening, then you cannot attend, you cannot go anywhere near those gatherings. Another type of gathering mentioned in hadith where Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam has clearly prohibited that do not sit at a table, yudaru alayhi al-khamar, where alcohol is being served. So you see, we have conditions, there are restrictions. A Muslim cannot attend every and any gathering. Then moving on, Quran explains that when you are at such a gathering, if you are at a gathering where there is the head of, or the host, or the head of the gathering, it is his responsibility to change the topic of the conversation if it is, for example, a conversation that is gone beyond the parameters that Islam has allowed. There is vulgar or backbiting or such type of conversation, then the Ra'isul Majlis, the person who is the head of the gathering or the host, should have the ability and the courage to change the gathering. If the host does not change the topic, then it is the responsibility of one of the attendees to change the topic in a very tactful manner. But if one of the attendees does not have the ability or the tact or the courage to change the topic of the conversation, then that person should leave that gathering and he's no longer permitted there. Now, Nabi Quran also states that إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ Indeed, the believers are those who believe in Allah and His Messenger. وَإِذَا كَانُوا مَعَهُ عَلَىٰ أَمْرٍ جَامِعٍ لَمْ يَذْهَبُوا حَتَّى يَسْتَأْذِنُوا If the head of the gathering has called a special meeting and your participation is required or your vote is needed, your input is desired, you are not allowed to leave that gathering. Hatta yasta'dhinu, till you get permission from the host or the organizer. If your absence is going to be noticed, is going to be missed, your input is needed, then you are not allowed to leave the gathering till you first seek permission. These are the guidelines the Sahaba are being given, ala amrin jami'in, that if Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam calls the Sahaba for mutual consultation, do not leave the gathering till you have first sought permission from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then when you are in such a gathering, Quran says, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu idha tanajaytum fala tatanajaw bil ismi wal udwani wa ma'siyati ar-rasul. When you are in these private gatherings, get togethers in these desi dawats, then fala tatanajaw, do not engage in conversation that falls within the boundary of sin and disobedience. Watanajo bil birri wat taqwa, have a conversation around piety and God consciousness and righteousness and virtue. فلا تتناجوا بالإثم والعدوان ومعصية الرسول وتناجوا بالبر والتقوى واتقوا الله الذي إليه تحشرون. And then Quran also says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, in Surah Mujadala, إذا قيل لكم تفسحوا في المجالس فافسحوا. When you are told to make room in the gathering, then make room for one another, be accommodating to one another, give someone a seat. This is during the time of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the backdrop behind this revelation, the revelation of this verse, is that the space was limited. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is sitting with his sahaba. It is jam-packed wall to wall. And some of the elderly sahaba who had participated in the Battle of Badr, they come in and they are standing looking for room. Where can I sit? Where can I sit? And there is no room. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam instructs the younger sahaba who have been sitting there for quite some time now to give up their seat. Now there were some hypocrites in the gathering. They make a big deal, a commotion, and a propaganda tool that, oh, we thought that there was equity and justice in Islam. There was fairness and brotherhood and equality in Islam. What has happened? What just happened? The youngsters were told to leave, and the elders were given their given their seat. Then Quran came, and these verses were revealed. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu idha qila lakum tafassahu fil majalis. When you are told to make room, then fafsahu, make room. Yafsahillahu lakum. Then Allah will make room for you. Allah will make room for you in Jannah is one explanation. Allah will make room for you in this world when you are in a such a situation where you are standing and looking for seat, looking for where to sit. Then on that occasion, Allah will put it in someone's heart to give to make room for you. So the head of the majlis, in this case it was Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, has the authority to ask someone to give up their seat for logistical reasons. If they are blocking the way, or for whatever reason a table needs to be emptied, they can ask, the organizers can ask the guests to give up their seat. وَإِذَا قِيلَ انْشُزُوا فَانْشُزُوا. And when you are told to stand, then stand. These etiquettes Quran has spelled out, as I mentioned in the beginning, micro level and macro level, individual level and at a society, how to behave with one another and how to behave in social settings. And Quran further explains that لا خير في كثير من نجواهم. Many of these gatherings, لا خير. There is no خير. There is no goodness in it. 9 out of 10 times they end up with backbiting one another. Allah is saying, La khayra fi kathir. These desi dawats, La khayra fi kathir. There is no goodness in it. Fi kathir min najwahum. In many of these private gatherings, illa, unless one of three things is happening, illa man amara bi sadaqatin aw ma'rufin aw islahin bainan nas. You are exhorting one another to give charity, you are encouraging one another to do good, or you are reconciling between two Muslim brothers. Then one of these three things is happening, then that get together is will be a source of reward and treasure for you. Otherwise, think of it. Every Friday night, every Saturday night, waste of time. Not only waste of our time, but it is a waste of our children's time. Our productive years are on the downhill, but their productive years are on the up and up, and we are wasting hours and hours every Friday and Saturday night at these social get-togethers. And then, but as I mentioned in the beginning, in moderation, lightheartedness, a good form of entertainment, but it should be in moderation. And then the overwhelming ayah of the Quran that we should be overwhelmed by, and that should be looming above our heads at these social get-togethers, is ma yakunu min najwa. Again, Surah Mujadala, ma yakunu min najwa thalathatin illa huwa rabi'uhum. Allah says, in these social get-togethers, social settings, when there are three people, the fourth is Allah. Ma yakunu min najwa thalathatin illa huwa rabi'uhum wala khamsatin. And when there are five, illa huwa sadisuhum, then Allah is the sixth. Wala adana min dhalik wala akthara illa huwa ma'ahum. And whether the number is less than this or more than this, whether there's 2 or 4 or 400 or 4,000, Allah is with them. Yunabbi'uhum. And Allah will tell them on the day of judgment, bima kanu ya'malun, what conversations they engaged in. So not one verse, not two verse, not three verses, seven verses of the Quran I have quoted in front of you regarding our social get-togethers. Clear, crystal clear verses giving us instructions which gatherings we can attend, which we cannot, and how to behave once we attend these gatherings. And then when we come to ahadith, there's multiple ahadith. I will mention only two. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, la yatanajar rajulan dun al akhar. If there are three people in a social setting, two should not engage in conversation privately, excluding the third. Why? Because this third person will think they are talking about me. If not, at the least, he will think, he will feel excluded. He will feel left out. And this also applies to a language. If there are three people and two are talking in a language that the third one does not understand, this is in clear violation of this hadith. La yatanajar rajulan dun al akhar. And then, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in another hadith, al majalisu bil amana, that the majlis, gathering, majalis, plural of majlis, any gathering, every gathering is an amana. By default, it is an amana. It is a trust. You don't have to say that whatever we are discussing in this room should not leave the room, or this is, let us keep it here, or this is just between us, or no, it is classified. Every conversation in Islam is classified unless it has been declassified. The default position is amana, is that it is a classified conversation. Why? Because when you say to someone else what has happened, what conversation took place, most probably you will not be able to provide the context or the tone of the conversation. So the person who was not in attendance will end up misunderstanding what was said. So al-majalisu bil-amana. And there are many, many other ahadith. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, la tajlisu, do not sit at the head chair, at the recliner, at the lazy boy, at the sofa, at that seat where the head of the household sits. He has been sitting in that chair for 20 years. You come for 20 minutes and decide to sit in that very same spot which has been reserved for him by his family. And that goes against the etiquettes of social get-togethers and gatherings. May Allah Azza wa Jal give us the tawfiq, the ability to practice what has been said and heard. And may Allah make our social get-togethers a dhakhira, a source of treasure for the life hereafter. Wa ma alayna illa al-balagh. Please pray your sunnah.